Mr. Bob Blackman, Lord Paul, and friends, good afternoon to all of you. It's a privilege to receive this honor today at House of Commons. And ICFAI, which is popularly known as ICFAI. ICFAI Group has got about 11 private universities. ICFAI has got 9 ICFAI business schools. And ICFAI has got a large distance learning program. We are about 3 decades pioneering this cause of education in this country. And we are very happy to stand here today and share with you why we are a great place to study in India. ICFAI is a great place to study, not because it has got 11 private universities and 9 business schools and a large distance learning program. ICFAI is not a great place to study because it produced thousands and thousands of students so far in the last 3 decades. Sir, ICFAI is not a great place to study just because we have given out degrees to many individuals by collecting fees. ICFAI is not great because it has collaborated with a dozen universities in the UK and a dozen more in the US and in various other countries. ICFAI is not just a great place to study because of all these factors. Education has to follow a particular philosophy. Principles driven out of philosophy will be implemented in the processes of education. We are committed to making the Indian industry competitive by producing one of the finest managers, competent engineers, and on the whole, the best human resources in the country so that the industry becomes very competitive. That becomes our philosophy. And we have over a period of time mastered the art of writing cases and developing the cases for industry as well as management community. Every second case that is sold by the Case Center UK is from ICFAI. It is a distinguished feature and achievement, and it gives great sense of pride for us to state this, that every second case sold by the Case Center, which was earlier called ECCH, is from ICFAI. And not many people find the place in the top 10 in the world, apart from ICFAI. I mean, in Asia, ICFAI is the only name that we find in top 10. We are also very happy to share with you here this afternoon that most of our students, whether they are from India or abroad, whether they have studied from abroad or studied in India with ICFAI, they continue to hold the spirit of education and also their success very high. And in the next few days that I'm going to stay here in London, we have set up a huge set of meetings with all the students who are present here working in various organizations. So thank you once again, all of you, for extending this honor to us.
What does it mean for the university to have achieved the eminent recognition?
For ICFAI, it is a big boost in terms of encouragement with respect to receiving many awards, and this one especially at House of Commons is a global recognition which we deserve. Having spent about 30 years in higher education in the country and having produced numerous successful students and contributed to the development of the country, we feel that this award goes to the dedication displayed by our late founder, Mr. NJSSV.
Factors that every university in India needs to work upon to raise their standards internationally.
In order to raise standards internationally, one has to first fundamentally strengthen in India. Nationally, one has to be strong. The core principles one has to stick to are not to complicate the education process, because it's a very simple process. In the first place, update the curriculum, open the education for multiple sources of learning, and in a way, develop well-rounded personality for the students. For example, a very good human being can only become a very good manager, a very good entrepreneur, a very good husband, and a very good wife. If that is understood very well by sticking to fundamentals, everything else will be of global standards.